how big a step is this? Because they look really cute, but they don't look that different from other mice.
Well, I think they look significantly cuter than mice. You know, one article actually yesterday said they're the most adorable mice that have ever been created. They did say it was an accident, which isn't true. It's been very, very targeted. And, you know, some people have already asked, you know, will the woolly mice increase the speed at which we get to a mammoth? And the answer is no. You know, I've been on the show before, and we've been editing our Asian elephant cells with mammoth alleles now for about 2.5 years. But what the woolly mouse does is it proves that our end-to-end process of understanding computational biology from this ancient DNA, making the edits, and then screening the embryos so that they're healthy, and we produce living, healthy animals works. And it would also worked in 1 month. So we started the project in September. In October, we had our first mice, and they had exactly the number of edits we targeted with 100% efficiency, and the exact phenotypes or physical attributes that we're looking for, which is a validation of all the edits we're making in the mammoth already.
This is pace then. What is the next step? Where do we get to see the next innovations for this particular mouse?
Yeah, so right now, you know, it's obviously clear that we can see the hair floofiness or wooliness, as we like to call it, in terms of the texture, the thickness, and the different ways it grows. We can also see they're slightly fatter and a little bit larger, so that goes into the lipid metabolism genes that we've edited from the mammoths. And then we can also see, obviously, the color, which is the color that mammoths are when you pull them from the permafrost and clean all the permafrost muck off of them. But what's really interesting is over the next 6 to 12 months, once we get approval from our ethics board and our IACUC board, we'll actually start to do behavioral tests versus wild type mice with feeding them different diets, increasing the temperature just a little bit to see how they behave in these different environments, to see if they do prefer cold tolerance. And that'll be another signal that we're on the right track with some of our mammoth edits that we're making in the Asian elephant genome.
Ben, I asked you it last time, and I sort of returned to it at this moment of geopolitical anxiety. A man who has built generative, well, you built AI companies, you've thought about defense, you've thought about space, but now is the time you're thinking about woolly mammoths and potentially extinct animals coming back. Push us forward as to why again, why we're doing this.
So we're going to lose up to 50% of biodiversity between now and 2050 if we don't do anything about it, right? We know conservation works. It just doesn't work at the speed at which we're eradicating species and changing the planet, right? So we need new tools and technologies in that. And what's amazing about this project is it gives us an opportunity to build new tools and technologies which can help humans, which we're monetizing. It also builds opportunity to build technologies that can help conservation, which we're giving to the world for free. We launched our foundation last year with a $50 million seed investment in it. And it also gives us an opportunity to inspire the next generation. So I'm really glad that I'm not dealing with defense or some of the other geopolitical issues. I think everyone generally agrees on both sides of the aisle and all over the world that losing species is bad. And we should do everything we can to protect what's here and build new technologies for conservation.
And that takes money. And boy, have you raised it, more than $435 million of it. Ben, the next stage is, how expensive is it? How much more might you need to raise?
You know, we're a technology startup that's also innovating new technologies for human healthcare and other industrial use cases. Like, we spun out Breaking last year, which is our plastic degradation company. We spun out Form Bio, our computational biology company for human healthcare. We have another one that may or may not be coming out at the end of this year. And so we will continue to raise money as long as there's investor interest and sentiment and they're excited about the mission. But I think genetic proof cases where we can identify genes and make 100% of precision edits using multiplex editing, making all these edits weren't stacked. They were made all at one time with 100% efficiency. That's just not something that we see in genome engineering, right? And I'd say that leading the charge in genetic multiplex engineering is probably a pretty large market long-term. So we will continue to raise more capital in the years to come.